I'm trying to get a release started, or you get a release out by tonight, so I gotta do a God mode playthrough and just test all this new stuff. There's so much new stuff to test. Why is that rain so weird? The rain's stopping! Oh man, that's gonna be a very... It's gonna be a weird bug. But yeah, there's so many little bugs I found yesterday because of all the new systems changes. There's like improvements to the input, improvements to the render, improvements to the AI system. All of those cause bugs. It's crazy. It's like the rain is just like really weird on this area. Oh well, but anyway, so yeah, I'm gonna do a God mode playthrough and see what I can find. Yeah, I did. I caught a lot of bugs yesterday. What's up, Alex Pita? How's it going? Well, the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start with a fresh saves file. And just check the basics, because I did some new stuff. I fixed a bug where if you start with a brand new saves file, it doesn't try and overwrite, it doesn't block your keyboard settings with its defaults. Before, if you tried to press a default key, like W, A, S, or D, those were all bound to stuff. If you tried to press any of those, it wouldn't work. So now it correctly handles that. I just want to double check that. Should I do? Actually, I'm gonna exit just to make sure it doesn't ask me to bind again. Anybody got a world seed they want to do? Garfield it is. Okay, good. It didn't ask me to rebind. Now I'm gonna plug in my controller. Make sure this is all feeling good. So I was just mentioning that I got a lot of bugs to get tested here. What's up, professional novice? Yeah, so last week was a pretty monumental week as far as like messing with the underlying systems. A lot of input bugs and stuff. So I'm trying to go do a God mode playthrough to catch any bugs that I just introduced by all that. Writing an essay for business? Right on. Yay! Intro. It's not actually new. Thanks, Weedabit. That means a lot. I don't have any god mode tools or anything because I started from a blank slate, so I probably gotta restart here in a second. Thanks, I'm glad it sounds good. Yeah. I can't wait to make that procedural. There's so many like little tunes that I'm gonna make procedural and just like mess with the melody a little bit. It reminds you of Axiom Verge? That's cool, that's a big compliment. Axiom Verge has some sweet intros, and so far the input feels good. I mean, nothing is really, it's the only difference really that you'll be able to feel is it goes from, instead of it being 33 milliseconds, it's now like 16 milliseconds, so it's like barely noticeably faster. So I'm not really noticing it yet, but there are some important input bugs that have gotten fixed this last week. This new beta will be released tonight. Really? Google made something like that? I'm sure they did. Oh, I'm wondering, like, why is it so... There. I can't run at 60 frames a second and stream at the same time. That's better. Getting some of those lately. You've seen them. Trolls. Thanks, PETA. Okay, here's a good place to save. Because I don't have any debug keys or anything. Need a few debug commands and stuff. I need any pause and at least these. Oh, wait, and skip intro, or skip to menu? Skip menu? Skip menu. I think it's skip menu. Yeah, skip menu. Okay, so I do got to get into god mode and try and, like, run as fast as I can through the game because there's so much to do and so much to check. Why didn't it skip the menu? Let's do this. What is making that noise? This guy. everybody been doing? What's new? What's the haps, yo? GitHub thing where you went, or when your GitHub thing? Not your GitHub thing, your Git thing. Did you go back through, like, Git commit by Git commit, figure out, like, where it was, or what? I'm so curious, man. Happen in the first room where you have this kind of puzzle. Draw a collector in the first frame and then all subsequent frames. Okay. That's why you were getting that one frame of like it flickering in. Yeah. That sounds like it probably was the case, huh? Related to that. Oh, secret! Good. I'm really glad nothing seems too broken here. I did fix a lot of bugs yesterday, so hopefully this is all gonna be pretty good. I can just put out this update. Yeah, I bet it felt great, man. That was a while. You were stuck on that for like a few days. Yeah. yeah, so far these changes to the momentum for the input, there's the momentum, there's combo hits, there's an increase to the amount of, or decrease to the latency for input, there's an input bug fix, all that's kind of adding up to a little bit better. The game feels a little more responsive, a little more, just feels a little better. Glad there's no obvious bugs yet. Those little things that I already got on my list and stuff. Spider died right in the middle of this thing, and Jib can't scan it. Platform. Rendered up flags. So an optimization I made yesterday to the render system was the way the render system works is it interpolates the movement of any sprite. So if a sprites all have a last position and a current position, so it during a game tick, it will actually interpolate the position between those 2 points. What's up, Raga Bunny? And so, but that was really inefficient for entities that never ever moved, like the walls. The walls never move. So I was like, oh, there's got to be a way so it doesn't try and do that for all the walls, and then everything else can have it. So the way it works now is if an entity has a move component, it will always do interpolation of the movement, or if it has this one little render flag, krender interpolate, then it will always interpolate its movement. And this thing, this idle platform thing, didn't have this interpolate flag and didn't have a move component. It was just moved via code. So it needs this interpolate flag to make sure that it draws correctly. So I've got to go back and take away the life container. It should float down from the ceiling again. I knew there had to be one or two more little things related to that. This was all yesterday's code. Yesterday's code. Why is it not skipping the menu? There we go. Work that time. Nice. All right. Jib get an upgrade where he raises his z-axis of colliding with things for x seconds or rockets too far away. It's a good idea. There's one situation where that would kind of break this a certain story element, though, in the cave where the rock falls down. Oh, no, I guess it wouldn't really break it because rock's stuck behind the rock and Jib wouldn't be. What's up, Blood? What's up, Turtle of Doom? What kind of game is this? It's kind of like Zelda. Kind of like the first Zelda. Spirits. Scanner drones. Oh, I got some scanner drones. I should use those. This area looks alright. I was wondering if any of these stores would have any bugs with the noose and stuff. Good, man. I'm great, yeah. Life's awesome. Just making my dream game. So anyways, the big thing I'm trying to test here is that, oh crazy, it's nighttime and I got in here. Where is the entrance? So yeah, basically it randomizes the order of the dungeons now. Oh, found a secret. Oh, I forgot about the volume, sorry. Yeah, I started with the fresh saves file, so that's probably why that was too loud. Oh, sweet, I found the shield before I even got the shield normally. Yes! That's a cool secret. So basically what I was saying there was that the game randomizes the order of the dungeons now. You know, I was always meaning to do that, but it was going to be such a significant change. So that's another reason why I'm doing a God Mode playthrough today, is just to check, you know, does the game still work? Does it, do all of the gate tiles still work? Like the Ghost Sword Gate, the Abominable Pillar Gate, all those other things that kind of guide you throughout the game, do those work? With the order of the dungeons being randomized. I think I coded everything correctly so that it puts the order of, like, for example, the ghost gate is always after you get the ghost pill, the ghost sword. But I'm just making sure by playing through. Yes, they kind of, the way that they were, that is handled is that the dungeons all increase in their difficulty and the size of the dungeon too, depending on which order it is. So for example, if the fire dungeon were dungeon number 8, it would have a lot more rooms in it, and it will have all the enemies would be more difficult, and there would be more enemies as well. So the game kind of naturally scales the difficulty of dungeons. But also some of the more important things are kind of like random, but yet they're sort of in a certain number. So like, for example, the fear dungeon is always like between dungeons 6 and 8, because it has to be one of the last ones because of the story and stuff like that eventually. And like the ship dungeon's always number 10, the tower's always number 9, the first dungeon's always the first dungeon, but it still randomizes its color schemes and stuff. What's up, Chow? This is a C++ game. The engine I'm using is called Cocos 2DX. What's up, Ichinicero? Thank you, I'm glad. That's a big compliment to say that it has a HLD feel. I started this game way before Hyperlight came out, though. And my main inspiration for this game is Zelda 1, the very first original Zelda. So, if anybody says this is a Zelda 1 feel, I'll be like, yeah, you know what's up, man. Oh, should I buy this? Proton Shield? Oh, I'm short. I could get fire, though. I'm definitely buying fire. That could really come in handy. Yeah, it definitely won't be the second one. The second one will be harder than the 8th. The map? Yeah. Wait, so what am I doing? Where the hell am I? Why am I all the way over here? I was trying to follow Zero. Okay, I'm gonna go back to this other dungeon. I'm gonna cheat. Because I gotta rip through, get as many of these done as I can. I'm cheating! Woo, cheating! Oh, I should check this out. Turn off cheat mode for a second. Oh, something weird's happening here. Why is there dialogue all the way at the bottom left of the screen? Okay, gotta fix this. What happened? Why is your dialogue all the way down there? Just fixing bugs as I go. Alright, so I'm gonna take off this story element, Vel 1. Why isn't... Oops. Why isn't skip menu working? Oh, because I have skip menu 0 up here. There we go. Alright. Vel, it's the her dialogue component. It's probably in the dialogue system. I think it has this function. Maybe it's dialogue component. Has a move or something? No, it's not here. Maybe it's the story system. There it is, move dialogue. All right, so if e.name is Vel, what's wrong with the dialogue? Set a little breakpoint here. Run it again. Oop, e.name.name. Hopefully it doesn't work this time. Because if it all of a sudden it works this time, I'll be like, what? Okay, good. Oh, okay, so it's not even hitting that. Oh, it's probably because she's floating in the cryo sleep. She's a different kind of entity. Where is her, where's she at? Vel. I think this is it. It's just Vel. She's like floating in cryo sleep. No, she has a name. What? But how does her afro stay so perfect? Man, she's magic. She has magical hair. I don't know. I don't know. Oh, this time it's hitting it. So why didn't it do that before? Her name component. Oh, this time it's working. Okay, so why is it failing? Oh, the dialogue's empty. What does an empty dialogue component can dialogue component empty is if it's not active and the layer's not null and the sprite's not null. Oh, and the layer has to be visible. You saw a South Park clip and someone put their username in the lower left corner. Are they trying to get copyright infringed? Or DMCA'd or whatever? What is it? What is it? What is it? Why is... Funny that someone was like, nope. Oh, they put their own username on top of the first person's username? You're making a Volfied kind of game? What's that? Oh, you close cut areas of the screen? Neat. There's got to be a really simple reason why this dialogue's appearing in the lower left corner. What does Rock have that she doesn't, as far as dialogue goes? Font, box color, text color, height, sounds. It's got all that. It's got an attack, a move component. Oh, it could be move. Oh, that would make a lot of sense. Does she need this? Flags interpolate? That might be it. Quicks. Kicks. There we go. That fixed it. Today's great warriors. Sweet, I love the music. Cheating. It's kind of almost like Breakout. Boogie, what's up, man? Is this it? Yeah, okay, this is Dungeon 3. Rockabunny's coded! So I didn't find... Wait, what dungeon is this? This is 3. So 2 would have been the second dungeon, but 0 eluded me. He like showed up and just teased me. Okay, I know the controller's working, I know it's feeling a lot better, so I'm gonna just go keyboard here so I can go faster. Gotta get a lot of bug testing done, just test all these areas, because I'm testing, just find the, you know, obvious bugs, get them fixed. Nice. Nice, Flood. Wait a minute, was there a... I think there were boss doors in the first dungeon. Was there? should check that. Okay, let me start a little bug list. Bastards are tough. I forgot about these guys. Woo. I'm glad I made that a little bit easier. We're getting trolls today. Twitch has trolls again. I don't think so. Yoda Blaster is a human. Not human. I got the ghost sword already. Ooh, did this guy just reveal a secret? Yeah, same one. Oh, I don't have the. I haven't gone to Dungeon 2 yet. Can't get through that door. I do have fire already, though. Behind the floor tile. Yeah, that one guy in that other room did, yeah. It was looking weird. He went behind a wall tile. Frozen! You guys are tough! Somehow I'm not dead. Scan stuff, Jim. We're still alive. Oh, that was lucky as hell. I must have had a quarter of a hit point, or like an eighth of a hit point. Something too low to even show. Scan stuff, man. He's having real trouble with these scanning things that are underneath other things that are. He's like, I really want to scan that. Maybe try scanning other stuff, man. There, oh, there he goes. Okay. It would be really cool if Jib should try scanning other stuff if he cannot get to a certain one, certain place by a certain time, something like that, at least. Mutinous had a good suggestion too of making him be able to go above stuff. Oh yeah, that's what I'm looking for. Scary fear, guys! Shave, you're getting stuck a lot. Why is that, man? Okay, so I've hit the limits of this dungeon without having the... Wait, so why? Oh, so I bombed through to get into the Verloc room, right? There's these tiles here that block me from getting in there, and then it's using the next... Yeah, I bombed in. Okay, so I have to go find dungeon number two to be able to get... Huh, that's kind of... I don't know about that. Because he stopped guiding me to dungeon two. Huh, what should I do about this? If you get to dungeon three and you haven't gotten the lighter yet, because of the way the world is ordered now, should you... Like, maybe at least, maybe zero doesn't stop engaging if you have used a compass. Because I think that's what happened. I used a compass, and so he basically stopped engaging. Hilbert, what's up, Hilbert 90? Yeah, that's awesome, Rocket Bunny. No bad. Good times, painful times, but good times. So I'm thinking this is dungeon three, not completable if you don't have lighter. And zero disappeared. Because I used the compass. Okay, so I'm gonna go try and find dungeon number two, or zero. He was starting to go like this way, I think. Dialogue behind this pillar. Desktop cross compatibility for games? For me, I think it's pretty important because I'm always switching platforms, and I hate having to go into Windows to play games, but I do it anyways pretty much on a daily basis. I think it sucks that a lot of game developers don't make their games very compatible with the stuff besides Windows. It just, I don't know. My Mac runs faster on a Mac, you know, so I go into Windows and games run a little bit, just a tiny bit slower, or else they're, I wonder what dungeon that is. I guess I'm the minority, though. I'm the minority Mac user. Mac preferer. Haven't found dungeon two. Ooh, this is a crazy dead end. Nothing seemingly here. Oh, you just mean cross compatibility with OpenGL. Oh yeah. I guess I don't know. It really doesn't matter if it's DirectX or OpenGL. There's the fire dungeon. I'm finding lots of stuff except for what I want to find. There we go. Yeah, I'm glad I noted that bug. That too. Yeah, you learn X and A, now you just love it. Yeah, Metal Vulcan. So Metal and Vulcan are faster though, from what I've heard, but what's the compatibility like on Metal and Vulcan? What's up, Billo Ho? Okay, God mode cheating, gotta run fast, gotta check stuff. As fast as I can. More things to check. Not more time. Got the lighter now. You're writing the next GTA 6. Oh, so Metal's Apple only. What about Vulcan? What's the compatibility on Vulcan? Isn't Vulcan like the next OpenGL, basically? If so, why aren't more people using Vulcan? Or writing engines that support Vulcan? Oh, there's a secret. Nice. So, let's see if this worked in not God mode. Yeah, okay. Got more cactuses. Woo! kind of isn't. Oh, it's lower level than OpenGL? So why isn't it catching on? Blood? Yeah, Billow, it is coming to Steam. We got a Steam link, right? There you go. Oh yeah. Oh, it's like extreme optimization, huh? Well, so far so good. Just mostly minor bugs I found, fixed along the way, mostly. Available 6th, 2006. It's wrong! It's a lie! Don't trust it! I know, I gotta fix that, right? I gotta update it. Don't worry, I'm gonna make some news. I'll have a big news announcement this December. I'll change everything then. Alright, yay, so now I have the lighter. I can go back to where I was trying to be. Oh yeah, I didn't find any other secrets in that place, so... Thanks, Sean got swag. It's coded in C++, man. The engine I'm using is called Coco's 2DX, but on top of that engine, I've written 73 or 4,000 lines of code. This game's been in development for about 2 years. I'm the one coding it, doing the art and the music and stuff. And it's coming out... Never! It's never coming out! No, I'm joking. I'm joking. I'm working as hard as I can to make it come out as soon as possible, but there's still a lot left to do. So, it's not quite ready. But yeah, the goal is for this to feel like Zelda 1, the very first Zelda. That's where the main inspiration for this comes from. That open world feeling almost. God, that's such a crazy term people throw around these days, open world. Right? It doesn't even mean anything anymore because some game developers have used it so much. But that's really the feeling that I'm trying to get at. You know, the Zelda 1 feeling was like you could go to any dungeon at first, you didn't even have to get the sword. It wasn't boxing you into trying to make any kind of certain decisions. I love that about the first Zelda. But on top of that, it's a procedurally generated game. So every time you start a world, you enter 6 letters, and those 6 letters generate your entire world. So basically, you can play the same world if you want to play the same 6 letters. It's always going to give you the same world, or you can play a different 6 letters and get something else. Do I think Monogame is just as good? I do not. I do not. I know it's not because Monogame is not as compatible with other platforms. Unless your purpose is just to write games for Windows, then yeah, then totally Monogame is awesome. And in fact, C# is a great language, and I'm not trying to knock Monogame at all. Monogame is pretty awesome. And one of my favorite video games ever was made in Monogame. That's Axiom Verge. But I'm just saying, they had Axiom Verge, the developer Thomas Happ had some problems because Monogame wasn't compatible with the PS Vita. So it is It is cross-platform, but it's not fully cross-platform, right? Or at least this was the case when Thomas Happ was making Axiom Verge. That's all I remember. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm totally wrong. Maybe it is PlayStation Vita compatible and other engines compatible. Nothing's compatible with the Vita. Yeah, Nidig, no, there's 26 to the 6th power world, so there's 308 million worlds. Nope, there's no randomness beyond that. There's only 308 million worlds. So those, whatever, whenever you generate a six letters or whatever, whenever you generate a certain world, it will always give you that same world each time, no matter the platform. No matter the platform at all. So if you're playing it on, you know, if you're playing it on Windows, it will always be the same world as you playing on Mac or Linux or iOS or whatever. Okay, so if I had fixed that bug regarding these, regarding Zero kind of disappearing, then I would have been able to find my way to Dungeon 2, and it would have kind of made more sense what I just did there. How crazy would our writing be with six letters? You mean only six letters? Playing roguelite? It's role playing. It's more like Zelda. It's more like the 2D Zeldas than a roguelite. There is a permadeath option, so when you start a game, you can like start it in permadeath mode. And permadeath mode means that when you die, you can't continue that world. So, and then regular mode is just what I'm playing right now. It's just when you die, you can continue. Yeah, there's no blanks, so it's just 226 to the sixth. But it would be so much better if it had blanks, right? And asterisks, pound signs, exclamation points, and all everything, right? Jeez, sorry, I'm jibbing you guys. Totally jibbing you. Okay, so what happens if you don't do all six letters? It actually, what happens, it seems like that it will allow you to not enter all six letters, but what's really going on behind the scenes is it takes whatever letters you gave it, generates a world seed, or generates a random numbers based on those letters you gave it, and then fills in the rest of the blanks based on those letters. So if you only give it like three letters, it will always generate the same world because it will always generate the three more letters based on that. So behind the scenes, they're really it's it gives you six letters without you even knowing. Even though you enter only one letter, it will fill in five more, but those five letters will always be the same letters based on the first letter. If that makes sense at all. Oh, Bob's. Yay! All right. Just kind of ripping through. If you guys are just tuning into this stream for the first time or whatever, I'm playing in God mode here to try and cover as much of the game as I can in one stream. Because I did a lot of changes this last week. There's a lot of things that might have introduced new bugs and stuff, so I'm trying to test as much of the game as I can. That's why when you see me press the 3 key, I go into God mode, and that means I can run through walls and run really fast. When I press the 2 key, it's hurting and killing all the enemies on the screen, just so I can go as fast as possible. You hate C++? I hear ya. There's a lot of things wrong with C++. Yeah, I definitely agree. There's so much that could be better about C++. Okay, I'm not gonna turn into God mode though. Fighting this guy. Oh wait. The boss doors all messed up there? They were. Whoops. I think this is time to play with the controller. Couple things to note. I think the blink, less blink cooldown from using the sword. Because I was swinging the sword and it wouldn't let me blink after a second, and that just, I know there should be some of that, but that was a little too much. And I think, check the boss doors opening in, what's this, Garfield? What room was that? 253, so that would have been 243. Okay, these are important. And no header files? Oh! Especially no header files, right? This was like a, this might have been a Z order issue. Garfield's a pretty good seed so far. A target game length? Yeah, it's probably about 2 to 3 hours. Friday becomes super game dev night? Nice, man. Oh no, that looks okay. It does, I mean, it looks kind of weird there for a second, but yeah, that's okay. Wait, it is wrong. Something's wrong here. Something is wrong here. What is this? Yeah. It's weird. It's like, there's no collision box for those. Oh well, I'll figure that out. It's on my list. As long as it's on my list, it'll get done sometime. Teleport cube, yes! Time to craft something. Oh, that's something I really gotta check, huh? I have not even thought about crafting. So, about 10 minutes for speedrunners. If a speedrunner could get this done in 10 minutes, I will friggin' take my hat off. Do you have a list of general things you want all bosses to have? Frequency of attacks based on dungeon number? Well, all bosses do change their health based on the dungeon number, so they have a health range. But yeah, I don't know. I'm gonna get to like refining the bosses when I get to refining the dungeons, and that'll be next month. So I will definitely I'll think about that. What kind of things should all bosses have? That would be sweet. That's like a dream of mine. Craft something. Fire sword, fire top hat, fire bombs, fire blink. Fire blink. I don't know, what do you guys think? I know, I think it's just I didn't recognize the number. They'll understand. If it was a friend, I would have answered it and said, hey, call me back later. But this is just some number I didn't recognize. So, okay, so far this is working. Yeah, that worked. No render bugs. Yeah, man, do your telemarketing other times, please. This dungeon right away. I'm totally ill-equipped for this dungeon. You don't even answer the phone? I usually don't either. Unless I'm feeling funny or generous. I'm feeling generous right now. I'll answer this. I want to make sure these doors still work. I want to find a locked door. There's one. All right, cool. It seems to be working. Waffles fueling game dev since. Right on. There you go. Good job, Rocket Bunny. Doing something daily on a daily basis for marketing. I think it's a great habit to get into as a game developer. Just constantly be, it's, you have to kind of be either a self-promoter or have somebody else do your promotion for you. So, I recommend being a self-promoter, because then, you know how to do everything. You don't need anybody else to tell you what to do or how to do it. Before game dev was a thing, yeah. Sean got swag. Should you make your own framework or use somebody else's framework? This is a pretty age-old question right here, and I got some thoughts on this. I think if you want to make a game engine, that's awesome. Make your game engine. But if you want to make a game, then use somebody else's framework, because you'll spend a long time making a game engine. And if you would really rather do is make a video game, then just make the video game. That's my take on it. But these other guys here, they probably have some great thoughts too. Salad Dongs is writing his own game engine right now, and he's doing an excellent job of it. Boogie makes games. Rocket Bunny's making games. Buds make games. Yeah, even AAAs don't. It's true. Blood always writes his own engines. Double blink! Yishnicero makes games. Lots of us make games. Coco's is a pretty good engine, but it is big. It's quite bloated. If you're gonna use Coco's, it's really nice to compile it only once. You know, you compile it, take your status, say, take your libraries that you use when you compiled it, and use those libraries instead of compiling it every time. Because otherwise, it's hell to go recompile your engine all the time. Yeah, I definitely agree that writing your own engine is a great learning experience, but if you all you want to do is make a game, then don't take the time to make a game engine, because you can spend a year, you can spend 2 years making just a video game engine. The better you make it, you know, the longer it's going to take. It's, yes. Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Use Rapid Game. Yeah, right, exactly. If you find making games engines to be more fun, that's your thing. Make the game engine. It just depends on what you want. I should mention also, Cocos has their own pre-compiled library command. Cocos has this like Cocos command thing, and it has a command to pre-compile all the libraries too. Whoa, Skullgirls was 10 years? Wow. Wow. 10 years just to write a game engine. Well, Owlboy took 10 years, but that wasn't... What did Owlboy use? Did Owlboy make their own game engine? Or did they... This is a funny tunnel. And by the way, who else has played Owlboy? Anybody played Owlboy? How do you like an Owlboy? I really want to know whether I should buy it. Oh, Owlboy's XNA. Okay. Oh my god! I'm doing this! I don't know if I can! I only have like level 2 items! This is like one of the hardest bosses in the game. And I'm almost dead. Skullgross itself didn't take 2 10 years. What? Oh, the jibdy bug. I hate this bug. Like, there's literally no way to do that. Well, look how many ticks I got up to. 55,000 ticks. Wow, that's a long, long time to make an engine. Indivisible? What's that? So nobody else has played Owlboy? Indivisible game. Oh. So is this kind of like Final Fantasy style like combat? Or is this sort of like... What's that one arcade game? Okay, I know things are working well this year. Nice, Raga Bunny. Oh, it's not really like Final Fantasy? Okay, I don't really need to fight this game, this dungeon again. But I am. Here, let's test it. God mode test it. Oh, there's a circuit breaker. Yeah. Oh, you can't hurt this guy. Oh, they bred raptors. That dialogue was, whoops. Let's make it so you can hurt him really quick, but he's invincible. Yeah, you like the guy? You haven't played it anymore yet? And he's, what is this guy's name again? I think he's T-Rex. That's a good name. Oh, his render component needs... interpolate. I want him to have a health component too, so he can get hit. And instant recharge, so he's just invincible. Oh, and collision. I guess he's a collision mask. What's Brutus? Brutus has. No. We spared no expense. That's from the Kickstarter. It's Brad's NPC. Brutus. Brutus has what I want. Health, HP, instant recharge, track status. Just instant recharge is probably track status would be alright too. And collision mask, default mask. There, so now I should be able to hit him, and also his dialogue should be okay. I should have a mass. Okay, now I can take off that story node. T-Rex. And do this again. Oh, and I shouldn't have the amber mosquito fossil. Okay. Still not getting hurt. Why is that? It's not worth it trying to figure out exactly why I do that. Well, at least I got that this dialogue fixed. Okay. Enough messing around. I gotta go test more stuff. Okay, that's enough testing, I think, in this dungeon. Oh, I want to take that, but I'm not going to. Alright, Vlad. See you, man. Thanks for stopping by. Hope things have been well with you. Yeah. RPGDX, it's good. From what I've heard from other developers, it seems like a pretty good engine if you like Java. Top hat drones, I'm buying them. I want my top hats to pick up bombs. So I have enough to get these bombs too? Almost. Did I spell it correctly? I use this, huh? It's right there, man. It's right there. Oops. Cheated. I cheated when I was cheating already. Okay, so put dungeon 4 here. Will we have different outfits? The plan is no. Because he's already got like 200 different frames or whatever. 200 different files of animations, all hand done, right? Over the last 2 years. And like, that's like 1500 different frames. So, but it is like top on my list. It's like one of the top things on my list is to make it so you can wear different stuff. If I write this new system for skins, basically it would kind of recompile the sprites at runtime. It would take pieces of sprites and then kind of combine them into another sprite so that it wouldn't be so bad anymore. It wouldn't be like 400 different frames or whatever more to draw. It would be easier. So if I can get the rest of the game done and really done well, and I have enough time, I would love to make a better skinning system so I can do that. Were those guys fiery? I don't think they were. Hold on a second. Those guys are supposed to be fiery. Spide fire. I think these might need to have flags. Interpolate. And probably the fireball too. I think the fireball had... No, the fireball didn't. Okay, no worries about the fireball then. Oh, Boogie, see you, man. Later, Boogs. Any tips for getting better at artwork? Yeah, I do have some tips for getting better at artwork. I would recommend watching a lot of art. I did write a little video series on how to get better as an artist, especially for programmers. It's called From Programmer to Artist. But the main thoughts there are just basically watch a lot of speed art. That's my recommendation. Go on YouTube, watch as many time-lapse artists as you can. Watch them make their art as fast as you possibly can, and you'll just start absorbing it by osmosis. And it really works, man. That's how I did it. I got good at art by just watching other good artists, you know? So I guess that was kind of egotistical to say I got good at art. I don't really mean to say that. I mean just to say that you can get good at things by just watching other people that have really good skills. So find people that you like, you really dig their art, you know, like, oh man, this guy's art is awesome. I really want to know how he does it. Just watch a lot of his art. And if you watch it in time lapse, you can watch a lot more of it. And what'll happen is your subconscious mind will start absorbing it. Absorbing all the information of how that artist does things, like how that artist, what process they use and stuff. That's the thing, is like the process of making art. That's kind of more important than the skill of making art, is almost just the actual process you use to make the art. Jaza, yeah? And it's also really fun to watch people make art. I don't know why, but I like... That's one of my favorite things to do on Twitch, is to watch artists. If you're into pixel art, you should check out the guy that's making Megasphere, Anton Kudin. He has a stream where he just makes pixel art a lot, and it's awesome. You can also use YouTube a lot for like watching people do art tutorials, like how to choose colors and other little basics of art like that. There's a lot of different YouTube videos out there that cover the basics of making art. Welcome, man. Of course. Okay, I've tested a lot of things so far, and things are turning out alright. Only minor bugs so far. I wonder what else I need to really, like... What are the big areas I need to test? Like, the other dungeons? Maybe dungeon... Yeah, I need to get into the other dungeons. Ah! Ah! Wait a minute, did it forget this room? Did I save and quit? Oh, no, I didn't forget. Alright. I must have saved and quit or something. Mm-hmm. Ah, it's fine. Alright, Okay, let's fight this guy for real, because the dungeon orders have changed. I really want to make sure the bosses are still feeling good. Wasn't too easy. Need to be able to visually distinguish between a bomb you placed and a bomb you can pick up. A sack. All right, give me a sack. go. This is definitely one of those dungeons I need to test because it has multiple floors. Stuff could have gone wrong. You little bastards. You little green bastards. You're green, burrowy bastardiness. Oh, here we go. This guy I should fight. Where's the other one? Yeah! Okay, cool. Wasn't that difficult. So I changed the order of some of the items too in the gates, so now acid is one of the gates. It makes a lot more sense for this dungeon to have the acid as the gate. The acid pillars. So we need something to make some acid damage. Either the bombs, top hat, or the ghost sword. Look at the ghost sword. Okay, those still work. That's good. What are you? Yes, lie detectors. Good for speed runs. Good for runs like this where you're testing everything. You gotta know where the dungeons are. Especially the next dungeon sometimes. This is all looking good. Everything here is in order. Except for this. Running around in circles. This must be a secret room. It's pretty obvious if you run around this whole dungeon. You can't get in this room. How do you get in though? Here? Is it here? Oh, there it is. What do we got in here? What is this? Hello. What are you guys doing in this locked room? Hanging out here, having a little party, huh? Nothing, there's nothing here? Such a jip, what the hell? Oh well. Okay, so I accidentally cheated and went through this room, but I would have had to use my ghost sword here with the acid to get past those. So far, so good. Everything is like structurally still okay. So far, just only minor bugs. And cactuses. Battlefield 1. Nice. This room get all lit up all of a sudden. I was not paying attention there. I thought it was dark at first, and then it's all lit up. Switch it to controller mode. Fight this boss for real. Bad decision. Crafting poison before fighting this guy. Oh man. Yeah, I got him. This guy is he should be harder when he spits out his poisonous stuff. You give me some freelance art design? Oh yeah. It is trial and error, right? Oh, I know, right? I know how you feel there. Whew. Yeah. People can be very difficult to work with sometimes. Or really easy. Sometimes very, very easy. You're like, this person I really get along with. And it's weird there's like differing philosophies on that, right? There's like the Steve Jobs philosophy that you have to have creative friction to create really good creative products. And then there's other philosophies that are like, no, you don't need to have all that friction to create awesomeness. I don't know. What do you guys think? Does anybody else have any thoughts on that? Creative friction? when there's a lot of heat and stuff like that going on between you and another person, does that actually make a product better, or does it it's just hard to deal with, you know? He's just gonna do this forever. Spitting out that stuff. That should be harder. When he drops that stuff, it should like drop more randomly on the screen or something, so you can get hit by it more easily. Yeah, it's been an experience. I think I know what you're trying to say. I've been there. I have definitely been there. Oh, it does mean that you both care, right? That's a good point. Boots now. Woo, I can run faster! Okay, that dungeon worked just fine. I'm glad. Where the hell am I? Oh, I was like, where am I? Where's my... Jeez, that's a... kind of crazy. I'll make a little note about that. The edges of entrance to acid dungeon should be diamond shaped or circular. What area is this? 170. Okay, I got at least one more dungeon in me. Rob the Swan, what's up, man? My old friend Zero, here he is. Luckily, I have the cup too. Oh, dude, what? Can you actually? Oh, you can walk down here. I'm like, this is crazy. He's walking down there. Rob the Swan, what's up, man? How you doing? How's your stream, man? You tend to make better things when you're working with someone that doesn't agree with everything you think. Right? There's pluses and minuses, huh? Oh, the stream was frustrating. Oh no, you lost 2 hours of a typo bug? God, oh, this is the worst. The worst, man. Oh, I know how you feel. I definitely had a few of those. You got started something nice going? Sweet. And how far are you at with doing a Kickstarter? Are you just in the initial stages of planning that, or what? I definitely want to hear more about it. Have the opportunity to support you. Sans Locket, right in the middle. Area 226. Mid-January. Oh, right, yeah. I think you mentioned that last time now. Yeah. It will make your screenshots look less like Minecraft. Yeah. Oh my god, I know, right? That's a big thing. Just making your screenshots look less like a really, really, really popular game. Because everybody will go, oh, it's just Minecraft. Or he's just copying Minecraft. I know what you mean. So what, tell me about it. What about your game? What makes it unique versus Minecraft? Not just visually, but like actually gameplay wise. What is it? What are your key differences? What would you like to get across to people on a Kickstarter or when they have the opportunity to buy your game or whatever? What do you want people to know that's different about you versus Minecraft? What's up, XP Coin? I think from a business standpoint, that's called like your unique selling point, I think. Something like that. Ow. What's wrong with this? KS is selling a usable moddable game engine. Uh-huh. All right. One of the single player total conversions should take several hours to play through. So the content. Ah. About 1 year to start working on Minecraft versus Monster Hunter and stuff. Oh, right. Okay. So that's right. That's the Monster Hunter part. So I guess how would you get that across? And quickly, as quick as possible. Like in 30 seconds or less, how would you get that across to people on your Kickstarter or whatever so they would support you? You know, they would get the uniqueness of your game faster. Sarah, isn't that great? It's not always like this. It wasn't always like this on this stream either. I mean, it was always kind of like this on this stream, but like, I've definitely had my fair share of trolls and crazy bad energy on here too. It's not always nice. Kickstarter, on the other hand, is a super positive place where everybody pretty much is nice all the time, which can be really, really refreshing. Oh, you won't mention the single player. Oh, okay. A Gmod of Minecraft. Oh. Wait, what's a Gmod? Oh, okay. Yeah, they are. The trolls are definitely minority now. Well, one more dungeon? I think I can do one more. Okay, I've never played Gary's mod. Mess up this door. Cool. I'm glad you got your USPs ready. Good. This was three door, four, five door. Boss door. Three boss door. Four boss door. This is it. Here we go. Flags fade out and interpolate. These boss doors already have interpolate. Oh, okay, that was it. That should work now. It's a unique selling point. Yeah. Oh, okay, Rob Swan, see you, man. Thanks for stopping by. Rock Bunny, I do have a suggestion on an article you can check out about how to do input. What was that article? It's on Gama Sutra. It's on the Steam controller and the PS4 controller. I think this is it. Yeah, this is it. But here is this. It's got golden rules of input. These are really important to check out before you start. Well, just things to keep in mind when you're creating an input engine. But where is? Wait. It's in here somewhere. Anyways, this is a really great article you should check out. Wait, what's this one? This isn't it. Sigbart here? Oh, Sig abort. Why would it abort right here? I guess it's either the director instance or the scheduler instance. This could be what I'm getting. Where I'm getting this one bug. On Windows, sometimes it crashes in the continue. This might be it. Yeah. So what is it trying to call? Is it the get instance or the scheduler? Both of those should be perfectly fine. Should never have a problem getting either of those pointers. This has got to be it. I'm going to put a little note about this. Game freeze on pressing continue, about 10% chance. This has got to be it. It's, I'm running out of steam. But I can do one more. Just one more. I've checked a lot of things, though. I've just fixed a lot of stuff. I'm glad I fixed those boss doors right there, though. That was important. I should really do, yeah. I should get to this last dungeon. I got it. I'll meditate here, use a cactus, then walk in the next room.
Yeah.
both shadows are still the same color. Oh, crazy. It's another little bug. Man, I've had so many bugs. So many bugs. Tell me I got a bio. Yes, I do have a biodetector. Using this, I'm going to the next dungeon. So one more dungeon. All the shadows are going to be this way the rest of the game. Cactus. That fixed it. Okay, so it had something to do with it when it was finishing up that last one. It didn't quite. Through any of this. Really? This is a weird world. You gotta go all the way up. Okay, I'm just gonna cheat. That still works too. Oh, I should check this. Everything's still okay here? Looks like it. All right, Fear Dungeon. Jim got stuck behind the... Oh, Jim, sorry, I was in god mode and I didn't let you through. The gloves. Key. If we need more puzzle patterns throughout the game, that'll come next month. Or locked doors. Seen this pattern turn out like that. Interesting. Now this is, this is the weird part. The door, boss doors are missing their collision component on the side. Just cheat while I'm cheating? What? This is the secret room? How did I miss a key here? This dungeon might be messed up. Oh man, I can't stream much longer. Tired. I think I've been streaming for a couple hours now. But I've pretty much covered most of the game. I found some of the more important things to fix up. I guess I can keep checking this later if I really want to go back and play the rest of this world. But let me see if this world is, if this dungeon is even completable. It's this secret room right here. There's one. You get one key in here. And then use it to go here. Second key there. Open this door. Third key here. Open this troll door right here. That's what I did. Yeah, this dungeon's messed up. There is a way that you can get through this dungeon, or I mean, you can play this dungeon out, use your keys in the wrong order, and it's messed up. Shit, I gotta note this. Garfield dungeon. You up keys on the left and not be able to get through. How did that happen? But I do know that I could have gone this way, and there's a pretty obvious secret wall right here. Bombs here. Another secret wall here. Which could get me into this room. Okay, it must have something to do with the tunnels. I know there is one case where where there's a certain situation where tunnels can kind of mess up key order. It's on my bug list, but I think that's another example of that same bug. Okay, that's fine. Okay, that tunnel works. Oh yeah, there was a video on it, huh? The video is probably really worth watching, because it's a long article. Correctly, you can get through this dungeon, or if you can find a secret, you can get through the dungeon. But I do need to fix that. There's just some situations where tunnels can kind of like mess up either the order you use the keys in. Yeah, it's like, or the tunnels don't quite tunnel into the right key level. Not exactly quite sure. died. I love this boss fight. Why is there no... I didn't get a heart from that, or a tooth from that one? Oh, wallop. That's a good word. That's a good seed. Wallop. Oh, it was invisible. I think it might have needed this. Either render up flags or equals k render interpolate. Let's check that out. Make sure. So I didn't kill that boss. And I don't have life container 7. Weird, I wonder why I wasn't at the end of the list there. Oh, probably because I saved with all those. Okay, that's fine. Okay, so I can start this again. Right on, bunny. Okay, after I fight this guy, well, I'm not even gonna fight him. Cheating. Okay, yeah, that time it worked. Tripled the shield. Okay, well, that's all. Oh, no. I can't, but this is so funny. It warped me back on this little island over here where I'd be totally stuck. Oh my god, it's so funny. Alright, bunny, see you, man. Okay, well, where are we? Area 040. I've never seen this bug before, this is funny. I got stuck out here from teleporting. Garfield 040 gets stuck on an island. Starting or teleporting in. Later, bunny. And I'm about done. I'm done. I can't do any more right now. So I got through most of the game. I got through 7 of 9 of 10 dungeons. There's still a little more debugging work I should do tonight because I do gotta test every little thing. I gotta get in there and test dungeon 8 and 9 and just make sure everything works because it just so many little things got changed this last week that it's good to have an eye on all these things. So thank you. Yeah, thanks a lot, HGCero. And cheers, everybody. Thanks a lot for watching. And as always, I appreciate your support and everything. So, check you out next time. Later, everybody.